It's absolutely brilliant to have Barney and the Circle here. Boy, in pleasure to hear about Barney and the Circle. If Virginia Chong door to any Ethiopian in your Barney and the Circle, we know Barney very, very well because he used to spend a lot of time in Gidor and he used to play in the Seaview and Rare Kinyadigan and the Dodge and all over. And I'm sure there are quite a lot of people here that Barney sang and at their wedding or at their, what they probably met in the Seaview. Put hands up. Who met in the Seaview or in the Dodge or in Rare Kinyadigan when Barney and the Circle were playing? Who? I bet you the place is full. So it's like... Manor Doi, Barney, is there. I was sharing when you are playing with Barney, where Kaisha Pinora, Amishongi Door. So Kay Evie's the Circle, while Barney, McDaid, Ahane, Michael Hayes, Noel Sweeney, and it's Patrick Doherty, and it's Ligi Jib Orta Hanig, Fergus Cleary, Isha, and some Wayne Coyle Foster. So to face the call, Robert Honort, I guess, Ernoy, it's 39 years since this group were together. You know, it's amazing how, you know, it's hard to sort of take that. Isn't it 39 years? You know, it's amazing. They played together, I think, in 1983, that was the last year. They came together in the 60s when it was Barney and Hugo. They won the Letterkenny Folk Festival in 1969, and then they got together, and then they got together as the Circle, and they played all over, as I said, and they were just amazing, great, great musicians. And it's amazing that they haven't been together for 39 years. So listen, there's a feast of music here tonight. Come on, I should pick all the other Galavage on the Bajar the Vasta, that Seamus McGee, he's in Shin, and said, you are called to the Ellen Chad on there, then Brí, Biddie. Hey, this is the job, but big Brí will announce the musicians later on. So we're so pleased to have Barney at the Circle here tonight. It's just amazing, and the crowd, we're so pleased to have you all here. Some people in Madurtma and Shaw and Kid Wittario. In fact, you know, Desi, hello Desi. Desi was telling me, Desi spent a lot of time in Gidor. He told me they used to call Gidor and this area the back country. So we're getting our own back tonight. Anyway, you're all very, very welcome. So, gonna hell you, Molly, Saladashamid. Why don't we just celebrate Barney's 80th birthday? He'll be 80 on the 30th of August.
Not too tall. You're all very welcome here tonight, and I'm very pleased and honoured to be asked to be here tonight to celebrate Barney's birthday, and also it's for a very good cause for the Donegal Hospice. So well done all of you for supporting it as well. And are we ready, Brí?
I don't know. Are you?
If you know the words, sing along and clap your hands and tap your feet.
It's good to see you, so good to see you. Oh, how I've missed you since I've been gone. And I've crossed the ocean, traveled to many lands. And it's good to see you, to be in your home. There's something in me that makes me wonder. There's many a land I long to see. Since I've been gone, and I've crossed the ocean, to see you, to be in your home. Thank you very much. It's good to see you all here tonight.
There are fine boys tonight, Dan.
Oh, they're great. We have them starting now. We'll keep Dan singing now for the few hours. And there's no guarantee down here either, so we'll be here till the morning.
Her name up there at the back. I said, there'll be a few musicians who'll come along and we'll get our sound check. And you see, these guys are so used to having roadies and whatnot, everything all done for them. You know yourself. So,
doing great.
Thank you all for singing. We weren't expecting the choir. Are you ready for song number two?
Yeah.
All right.
Good on you.
Yes.
Galway Bay, KOT,
1969. They won the very first Letterkenny Folk Festival Pops, Barney and Hugo. And I only found this out during the week when he was being interviewed for the Donegal News that the two boys got invited to Florence in Italy. And all this time, I thought that Dad's early trips were overseas to Aaron Moore. So I'd like to get Hugo and Barney. Have you anything to say there, Pops?
Yeah, another Kenny was Barney and Hugo, but in get over Barney, always Hugo, and that's all we're ever called, Barney, always.
Shut up the whole door. Michael Hayes, well done Michael. We heard from Hugo, we heard from Dad, and we're really, as well, you've heard from Anne. Behind us hiding here, we have John and Sheila, absolutely stalwart musicians.
Our
orchestra. And we'll hear from them later on as well. And there are a few guests hiding down in the audience. And remember, if anybody has any requests, as Daddy always says, just put them on the back of a 50 euro note and send them all here for the Hospice and we'll make it happen. Is there anybody here from Aaron Moore tonight? Like to hear next? Let's shout your name up. Come on, who do you want to hear next? Elvis. That's probably like the only person that's older than this lot. Okay, I think what we'll do is he's got the microphone right in front of him. He's known as Mr. Panto. He gave me my first stab at choreography many, many moons ago. The fantastic, wonderful Mr. Pantomime, Patrick Doherty.
Thank you.
A wee story before we go to Barney in the circle. We were playing down in Ballyhoffin at a wedding one day. I think there was only three of us in the band at that stage, myself, Barney and Noel. And this was the time weddings used to be early. When you got married at 12, everything was over by 7. And we had played the wedding from 4 to 7 o'clock. And our next booking was in Killybegs. And we had to drive from Ballyhoffin to Killybegs. And I remember on the way over, we went through Ballybuffet and Donegal Town, which a whole rack of places. And Noel said to Barney, "Jesus, Barney, could you not have got a booking a wee bit closer to home?" So we got to Killybegs anyway, and went into this pub, and your man that owned the pub came up to us and told us, it was the height of the troubles at the time, and he said, "There's to be no party songs tonight, boys." We said, "Fair enough." And we were very tired after travelling from Ballyhoffin to Killybegs. So we got into the singing anyway, and it wasn't going great, but it was going okay. And I said to Noel, "Do you think we'll be coming back here again?" And Noel says, "No, I don't think we'll be coming back here. Give me a G." And we launched into "It Was On a And we never got another place. Story that we can't actually tell. There's a whole lot more we couldn't tell.
There's children in the audience, Barney.
Oh, no.
We were those children in the audience once upon a time. Boys and girls, ladies and gentlemen, are you all enjoying yourselves so far? Can you imagine if we practiced? It'd be amazing. So we're going to go on. I think maybe it's time for Noel Sweeney to do a wee piece here. He's got a few wee recitations, or he's got a song. Which would you like to hear?
A recitation. I don't know whether you're calling a recitation or you know, or thinking of a couple of recitations. I was thinking about the audience here tonight, and I thought the one about the old hen might fit the bill. There's a lot of old chickies here tonight. Could we have the lights a wee bit up, maybe in the hall? One of the reasons why I always get up is because if we walk about too long, we get stiff, and if we sit too long, we get stiff. This is the old hen that had come to the end of its career, which I'm sure a lot of us has reached that stage of anyway, it was sitting up in the gatepost, and the young birds was all fluttering out and in, and them wild noise and the smell of perfume off them and lipstick and one thing and another. The old hen started reminiscing about the days gone by, and oh, it was a sad tale. The old story went something like this. What do I see now how it starts?
Mary,
you always get to come to this stage in your career, you get what they call moments. What do you call them? These moments could last for half an hour. This morning on the nest I sat as I did in days gone by. No country age can I produce, no matter how hard I try. The tears roll down the old rooster's face, or he's always standing near. Well, he joins me in the chorus when I cackle loud and clear. Now, cackling is a language known only to us birds, and he always tries to comfort me with a few consoling words. He says, "You've had a long life, Nora, and don't you fret because it's only natural at your age you're going through the hen of paws." Now, as well I do remember when I was a pullet fair, let it be at an owl hen party or a cockfight, and I was there. I was a favourite with all them young roosters, and at them I used to tease. I used to wear the feathers just a tat above the knees. Oh, I'll never forget when the fox came, how quietly he did sneak. The blood ran cold within my comb, and my heart was in my beak. And when he made that awful spring, I fell off my perch in fright. Sure, he took my great-granddaughter for a supper that same night. Now, the bird they call the rooster, he's also known as the cock. He's a dedicated father and a protector of the flock. Now, he loves them little chickens, and he's a favourite with all them old hens. But he always gets fierce randy when he sees me in the pens. Now, for 3 long weeks each year o'clock, that's how I lost my shape. So a family of 20, it's all scratch and scrape. Now, the 20 orphan chickens is a sight you'll often see since they started incubating over there in the modern hatchery. the 20 orphans' chickens had never seen their mother's life. They were never educated on the simple facts of life. You need a mother's guidance from the day you start to walk, in case that you might fall in love with some crafty, cute old hawks, you know. I'm getting old now, and days, I think I'm glad, because them young pullets nowadays, they have morally gone mad. I have no time for insemination. I prefer the old way still. I never used contraceptives and I was never on the pill. I wouldn't use a condom, none of it, to save my life. That old rooster might be HIV, but I'm 25 years his wife. Dead, life's nearly over, you know, and when I look back, I suppose life was grand. All's left for me now is a plastic bag with a Dunstores brand. And with chicken on the menu, you won't have long to wait till my cackling days are over and my breasts will be on the plate.
Michael Hayes, and Michael is living in Derry now, and Michael left the circle and his life, but you know, he was always coming to Gidor and around Letterkenny, Ballyliffin, the whole place, so then he had to, you know, take it down a notch and ended up doing the cruise ships and having to work in Portugal, the Crether. So it was really sad.
Fergus gives up so much time.
He left two people dying in Galway to come to this.
Well, I'm letting you die of thirst because we're slowly getting the water up for the bar and you two are at the last of the trough, so you'll get there.
I don't know
where
it's at, boy.
Tell me
yarn. Will I get up, will I? Aye, get up the Congratulations, sir. I'll give you one note of caution, because I've been there and I've done that. The going gets tight, sir, when the candles cost more than the cake. Sorry to be so pessimistic, but I don't know by home, you know, Annie Lifley was 103. And the minister used to come and visit him every birthday. You're 103 now, Sammy. I'm 103, Your Reverence. Aye. And ye love me the good book all your life. I do all my best, Your Reverence, to love me the good book. Aye. And you've no enemies at all. I can truthfully say that, Your Reverence. I have no enemies at all. You're a great man, Sammy. How did you manage it? Well, I'll tell you how I managed it, Your Reverence. I outlived all the bastards. He never was in Dublin until 1992. And you all know what happened that year. Donegal won there. For the first time ever. And Al Callaghan says, "My Christ, if ever I go to Dublin, this is the year I'll go." And wee Jimmy was beside him. He says, "I'll go along with you. I have a bus ticket." Two of them onto the bus, never from Dublin in their lives. Way up. And when they got to Dublin, the bus driver, he started to call out Garter Street, Parnell Square, O'Connell Street, Henry Street. Wee Jimmy says to Callaghan, "Paddy, I think we should get out here." "Not at all, not at all. You wait until your name is called." And fared well anyway, until they got to the bus station. The driver says, "This isn't bad, you just have to get out." They got out and they seen a cafe, and they had a burger and a cup of tea each. And wee Jimmy went home again on the bus because he had a bus ticket. And Callaghan got a taxi and said, one of the best hotels in Dublin." "Aye." Taxi man took him there, up that steps there, there a great hotel. Callaghan got out anyway. And there was a wee man come out with a swallow-tailed coat on him. "Allow me to take your bags to the hotel, to the room." Away down the corridor and into the lift. And the wee man with the swallow-tailed coat pressed the button and the door slid and nearly cut the arse of Callaghan. He just went into the lift and, "Jesus, the room is very wee." No, this is just the lift up ticket to your room. Up three stories, all grand, big room and carpet and jawbox, everything you could want, mirrors and everything. "Now, sir, when you want to get back to the ground floor, press button G and you'll get down." Callaghan managed that rightly and he landed down to the reception area and he looked around and he seen the bar. And he went over there and he thought he'd have a double whiskey and water. And that was served up to him and he took a sip out of it. And he says to the barman, "I say, young fella, what did you put in that glass first, the whiskey or the water?" The barman says, "I put the whiskey in it first." "Oh, good, good. We might go on it yet." He slept rightly and he'd his whiskey in and he come down in the morning. And he says to the wee man in the swan-tailed coat, "Where's the eating house?" "Oh, you mean the restaurant, sir? It's over there and round to the left. As a matter of fact, it's quite busy. You wouldn't mind sharing with that gentleman at the top left?" "Oh, not at all, that's all right." He sat down there. Now, Callaghan wouldn't have been a great hand at the reading, you know, but he wasn't going to let himself down. He got the menu and looked at it. He says to the wee girl, I'll have that there, actually, and chips." "No, I'm sorry, sir, you can't have that." "Why can I not have that? What's it on the menu for if I can't have it?" "No, sir, I'm sorry, you can't have that. That says closed on Sundays." When he heard that, he settled for the fry. And the two of them had the fries, And your man, that's the first time your man spoke. He says, "Bon appetit." And Callaghan looked across and he rose and he shook hands with him and he says, "Paddy Callaghan." The wee man with the swallow-tailed coat seen that, he says, "Wait a minute now, Paddy," he says, "left the bread." That wasn't that man's name at all, you know. That's a French expression, "Enjoy your meal, bon appetit."
I didn't know that. I'll be ready for him tomorrow morning. And tomorrow morning, Callaghan took the four out of your man when he came, and he says, bon appetit. And the Frenchman runs and he shook hands with him and he says, Paddy Callaghan. And he says, and there was like Rolls Royce car in the car park and it was rocking away. And your Callaghan's knocked on the window of the wee year and put her head out. And your car's rocking away to you. Aye, we're doing a wee dance. What kind of a dance he's doing? It's a samba. That's great. He went way down and he fed ducks at the bottom of the pond and he come back up again. The Rolls Royce is still rocking. Aye, you're dancing away. Aye, what kind of a dance he's doing now? It's a rumba. That's powerful. That's great. And then had a cup of coffee and he looked out the window and the Rolls Royce was still rocking. He said, what kind of a dance are you doing now here? Are you doing the bossa nova? No, I'm doing the boss a favour.
It's 10:10.
Do
you want to hear one more?
I might as well finish him now, the adventure in Dublin. The big day came, it was time to go to the All-Ireland, and up they went walking up to Croke Park, and Callaghan coming on traffic lights. What would the meaning, he says to the Dublin, what would be the meaning of that there, a red light and a green light shining time about? Oh, the Dublin says, when the green light's on, the Englishman can cross the road, and the other way around, when the red light's on, the Englishman can cross the road, when the green light's on, Paddy, the Englishman can cross the road. Miss Callaghan looked away for a while. Jesus, it doesn't give the orange man much of a chance. Yeah, they won anyway. They won. Donegal won the All Ireland. Celebration! We give them another cheer, even though it's 20 years ago. He got plastered in the hotel, and it was time to go home the next day, down to the bus station. And there was a sarcastic bus driver, the bus is full, sir. You'll have to wait for the next one. How long will it be, says Callaghan. And your man says, it'll be the same length as this one. And Callaghan says, will there be a gobshite like you driving it? He got home. And when he got home, there was a catalogue shoved in through the post. He had never seen a big red catalogue. Start looking at the catalogue, jeez. Oh, there was nice women. Oh, Christ, isn't that nice? One nicer than the other. Not out of the road either, 14-year-old 99. That's no bad for a woman, The neighbour come in and he said, look, I thought she was far more interested than showing in the book. I might put in for one of these women. Your man says, I put in for one, surely they're cheap at that. The boy was back 3 weeks later, he said, did you put in for one of the nice girls in the book? Oh, I did, the nicest one in it, 49 euro 99. Your man says, do you think is she coming? Oh, she's coming. Her clothes come yesterday.
Surprises while we do it after the next song? Huh? We're good to go? Okay.
Hi Barney, I'd just like to wish you a very, very happy 80th birthday from myself and indeed from Coles with Litcher Cannon. It's always a pleasure to have you at our sessions on a Tuesday night in Sister Sarah's. I've shared the stage with you many a time, from the old pantos back years and years ago to singing competitions, etc, etc. So I hope you have a great night in Amharclann Gador tonight, Friday night, and many, many more happy birthdays in the future.
Hey everyone, Paul and Larissa here, wishing Barney and the Circle all the best for tonight. Thanks everyone for the support, hope everyone has a good night. Sorry we couldn't be there, look forward to seeing everybody soon though. Have a wonderful evening.
Boss. Greetings from Galway. Barney, sorry we can't be there with you tonight to celebrate your fantastic birthday. Glad you got to this birthday and hope there'll be many more. You've always been a brilliant, fantastic brother-in-law to me and to all of our family. And thank you for that. Thank you, Kate, for bringing him into our lives. I think it was the best decision you ever made, Barney, was to marry my beautiful sister, Kathleen. For all of us.
Barney, I hope yourself and Kathleen have a great night there with all your friends and family.
From Pat and myself, a sincere congratulations and best wishes from the Toner family.
Good luck, Barney.
Good luck.
Happy birthday, Barney. On your 80th birthday, have a wonderful night. All our love from Madge, Huey, Owen, Hugh, Brian, Breda, Gary and Michael, and of course, Duke.
You don't have to be good, we've got away with it for years.
It's kind of like Murphy went into the divorce court one day, and he was sitting there in front of the judge, and the judge says, "I've looked over all your files and everything," and he says, "I've come to the conclusion," he says, "I won't give your wife €750 a week." And Murphy looked up at him, he said, "That's great, Your Honour. And tell her I'll give her a few bob every now and again when I can." Preaching says she didn't know what I'm doing out in Barney's house, whether it was the good tea or Mammy medicine. But it was in one night that the two of them were sitting there, and you know, it's amazing. So this is a wee kind of sing along songs. Share the silence, finding comfort together the way old friends do. And after fights and words of violence, we'll make up with each other.
Martin has touched on something very important there, and you know, Mary Sweeney is down there in the audience, and she said it earlier, and Dad said it in his interview earlier today. You know, some of you were listening in, and maybe in the paper interviews. As I'd grown up, and I'm sure my siblings out there will all testify as well, Dad did so many bookings, the boys had so much crack together, but it was Kathleen that was rearing the seven kids and manning the phones. So I would like to thank Mum on behalf of Dad and all the circle for everything that you have done, Mum, for the all of the years through Barney and the circle. There's just nobody like you. Bully boss, for to have our your own local hero, Mr. McGee, is going to bring us into the interval. He's up there and he's singing along. I can hear him louder than anything. And before that, we're going to have Caela, Manine Hain, obviously she can order a casu for Konya Grandpa, for Konya Amrita. So any of the kids down there that know this song, you can join in as well. Okay, so Caela Carr. But why lumps Seamus McGee, a heart of a statue shaw in Amharclann, it was a couple of orin at Yench Liv, August in Yashin, Bay, Interval Buck, August in Shin, Bay, Orinella. Do you want this microphone? No? He's not patient at all, is he? We're going to, he said you can all dance in the seats if you want to. Is that right, Seamus?
That's right.
That's
right. Alright, hello there, everybody. Jesus Christ, you can do better than that. Hello there, everybody. How many of you have heard of the name Seamus McGee before? How many of you couldn't care less whether you did or not? All right. Anyway, it's great to be here. Well, Gilligan will be leading, yeah? I trained Gilligan, well, I was thinking, well, but unfortunately, came with you. I'll hear the young song of Gilligan, but yeah, for so. If it's a fair tradition, you when the young song, not understanding anything, would it be? No, definitely not. Anyway, I'm going to start off with a little song that's very appropriate. It's simply called Together Again. And it goes something like this.
Ladies and gentlemen, it's an honour and a pleasure for me to be here tonight to sing a couple of songs for the man himself, who's celebrating his 80th birthday. Jesus, Barney, we go back a long time, I can tell you. From the days of the Seaview and whence at the new hotel, yes, the Austin and all that. Come on, give him a big round of applause. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday, dear Barney. Happy birthday to you. Oh, I don't know what I know about. But where would he be without the one and only, the daughter's Bridgie? Give her a big round of applause, Bridgie. I don't know. It's a long time, actually, since we've seen a good crowd like this in the Amharclann in the door. And it takes the circle. And it takes Brí Caela Carr to organise it. Give her a big round of applause again. I'm going to sing two more and finish with the song that's the reason that I'm here today. Okay, but in between I'm going to sing this wee song, very specially for my good friend all the way from Dunluce down there, Paddy McCafferty, doesn't go to Beats and Chanette. Yeah. Come on, thank you, brother, bless you, brother. Like I said, Niall, it's Kieran and everybody up there on sound, it's mine, it's Anrith. This is Ligi Jair and Sean Foster. Sean, we're on about that onion, life turned her that way. And it goes something like this. When I recorded it way back, if she seems cold and bitter, and consider all she's gone through. Don't be quick to condemn her for things she might say. Just remember, life turned her that way. She's been walked on and stepped on so many times, and I hate to admit it, but the last footprint smile, she was crying when I met her. She was harder today, so don't blame her. Life turned her that way. Jesus, the curtains frighten me. She's been walked on and stepped on so many times, and I hate to admit it, but the last footprint smile, she was crying when I met her. She cries harder today. So don't blame her. Life turned her that way. So don't blame her. Life turned her. My little son is up there. He's the band here tonight for me. Give him a big round of applause. Ian McGee. And my own other half, Sarah, she's out there serving us all night too. And she's hoping that you'll all go drunk now during the break. I'm going to finish up with a song that's probably the reason that I'm here tonight. It's a song that was written for me by Danny O'Donnell. Way back years and years ago, As a matter of fact, it's probably 18 or 19 years, and it's been with me ever since. One of the biggest hits, probably in Donegal, and one of the biggest hits in the country, actually, down through the years, simply called Come Home,
Danny Boy.
Danny Boy. Good on you. Here we go. So, EY, enjoy the break. Don't drink too much. Back in the 60s, I remember Irishmen emigrating to build themselves a better life all over the world. But some of them didn't turn out that way. You see, for one reason or another, the bottle became their best friend. So they went on the streets to try and hide the pain, the heartache, and the shame. This song is dedicated to them, their families, and their friends. In the West End of London, I saw him sitting there. He called out, "Hey, young man, what's the time?" And as I went to tell him, I saw that he was wearing an emblem from old Ireland on his coat. I said, "I see you're Irish. What part do you come from?" He looked at me with peering eyes of shame. "I come from dear old Donegal, but it's been so long ago. Still voices keep calling out my name, singing with me, 'Come home to where you belong, back to Bunkrana, back to your home.'" Since I left my homeland, but the pressures of life were just too much to bear. So I walked the streets of London and found comfort in the wine. But I still hear strange voices in the air. Everybody singing, "Come home,
Barney in the Circle's gig tomorrow night in the Amharclann Gador for Barney McDaid's 80th birthday. I want to wish Barney a very happy birthday and to thank him in the Circle very much for thinking of the Donegal Hospice, and to, from everyone here, thank you so much, and I hope everyone has a great night.
Hello, my darling brother Barney, just to wish you a very, very happy 80th birthday. Seen your picture on the paper at the weekend and you were looking very, very well. I hope you have a great night in Gador and love to Kathleen and all the family. Enjoy yourself. Wishing you a very happy 80th again, son. Love you. Bye.
Hi, Barney. Greetings from Clydebank. Weather beautiful. Hope you have a great, great night in Amharclann Gador on the Friday night. Have a great birthday. Say hi to all the boys in the band. We're having a great time here. Happy birthday again. See you next week. Bye.
Hi, it's Margot here, and I would like to send special, special birthday wishes to a very special man. Barney, I believe you are the lovely age of 80, and you don't look a day of it, but you're very, very special, and I just want to add my congratulations to you. You've been special in the past, and you're special now. Happy birthday. God bless.
Because of everything, and the girls are so, they're so kind, they're so good, that they're going to stay on afterwards, and we'll take all the guitars and everything out, and sure, anybody that's not in their man rush home, sure, we'll have a wee session out the front. Are you all right with that, are you? And there's been no dancing on the tables, it doesn't end well. Now, I have a brother all the way from Philadelphia that came home yesterday for this, John, and he told me, before we go on with the music, he says, you know, these guys, they really need to hear a story of something that happened between Noel and Michael. Once and for all, to put it to bed, what really happened about the time, about setting the news on fire or something?
No, I think I was involved in that too.
I took it up. At the time, I worked in Piscard's music shop. And I put the sign on the window, it's been Piscard's shop, saying, sign pound owner can apply within. And of course, after about a week, the sign disappeared and all got it back and blah, 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 blah. And one day, I was finished my lunch early and I was sitting in the car and I was reading the Derry People and Donegal News, and quite peacefully, and smoking a cigarette at the time, I'm
outside the post office.
And all of a sudden, the paper went on fire in my hand. And Sweeney had pulled up in the car, having somebody out teaching him how to drive. Now, he was teaching him a lot more than driving, you know, setting papers on fire. And he fired a piece of paper in the wind and my paper went in fire. Do you remember that?
No, no, you're mixing me up. It was my father, maybe. It was my father.
You said to the driver, slow down here. I think that's Michael Hayes' car at the post office. Michael had a bag against the wall and the fucked up.
No, I'll tell you, that was a pure accident, because at that time there were no word of it. There was even dirt to come in at that time. And there were no word of it burning anything. And I just burned about a paper and threw it out the window. And I happened to go on the window and land in his paper. I never meant nothing by it.
It was a private car, and you were sitting on it. And when you'd done that, you got up and looked all over the top of the seat against the sea. And there he was out in the middle of the street.
Agenda. Well, we don't know. We thought we were finishing about now, so I think there might be a song or two or a
medley. There was a woman had three sons in the fire brigade. And she shouts up in the morning when she got up, she said, who wants bacon for their breakfast? And all shouted down, me ma, me ma, me ma.
Job, you can play the guitar, Pet. Right, you might notice that there's a straggler on the back of the stage. I don't really know if I want to hear this man singing, because the last time I saw him singing, it was Christmas Day and I was in labour up in the labour ward. And Daly's you said, he played the hospital in Rhea's Wains. We always went round to them dancing and whatnot. And this year, anyway, I knew I was expecting Ben and things were happening. And thought, you know what, now and we go in nice and early because Dad comes in at 3 o'clock on Christmas Day every year without fail. So we'll go in now early and then we'll go up to Mum's and Dad's and we'll pretend like nothing's happening and happy days, we'll go back to the hospital, job done. So that was the 1 year that Dad decided to join the Church of the Irish Martyrs Choir. So he said to all the boys, us and myself and some of the lads in the circle, and all, we go up and we do Christmas Day every year, 3 o'clock. Would you like to come along? And the boys were like, gee, that's a great idea. Well, surely, but 3 o'clock's a bit late. How about 11? So greetings up. Up onto the machines, checking how everything's going, and that's fine. And next thing I couldn't believe it, Rudolph the red-nosed reindeer on the accordion coming down floor B. Georgie Riley, the wee nurse at the time, she runs out, she's so excited, she says, your daddy's here. I said, you don't say. Does he know you're here? No. So next thing she thought was a great idea. Daddy comes in carrying the accordion, nearly drops it in shock. I nearly dropped in shock because not only that, but not only the circle, but all these men from the choir coming into the ward. And how does Daddy recover it? Oh, well, sure, we're here now. You might as well sing us a wee song, did you? And the leader of the pack was none other than the straggler at the back, so I'm getting my revenge on him tonight, and I'm going to get Tommy Daly to sing you all a wee song.
Tell you I'd on the delivery. Oh.
you've been getting lessons. I think Catherine Jack down there was teaching you whenever I didn't know about it. Noel or Patrick, or the two of you, you ready for...
Here we go.
Good on you.
You are my sunshine, my only sunshine.
Did you all know it was Barney's birthday today? Well, it's not today. And what we'll do is we'll try and switch, whenever you're singing, we switch the mics over to myself and Aunt Betty here are going to be a bit like Ant and Dick and try and put the mics wherever the singers are. So ladies and gentlemen, not seen in 39 years, jump in when you want boys. Right, Barney.
I was no more than a boy.
for Pincherry Mountains. Met Captain Brown and his money was counted. I first produced me pistol, I then produced me rapier. Since then, and deliver for you one, we both the same mushroom dummy. Yes.
everybody's thinking, what do we sing next? We joke, Fergus.
Want to get up?
Oh! Michael, Fergus needs your stick there a wee minute.
All right. He went up to the priest and he says, what kind of a disease would lumbago be? He was a rough and ready character, you know, and the priest thought this was his chance to reform him. He says, me good man, you get lumbago from drinking too much, smoking too much, taking drugs, going with women, married women, other men's women, and the only way you'll get rid of your lumbago is to cease these evil activities immediately. And your man says, well, I haven't got lumbago, Father, but I was reading there in the paper that the bishop has it. I don't know, this crack here now, this playing music, I don't know what's good at it, because one time I tried a song or two, and when it was finished, half of the crowd was clapping, and the other half was booing. And I thought I was holding my own anyway, till I discovered the half that was clapping for the half that was booing. And a tiny yarn one time, and when I must have been laughing wondering about it, because when it was finished, there was only one man left the hall. He says, well, congratulations to you, sir. At least you stuck it out to the bitter end. Aye. He says, well, I wouldn't be here either, only I'm the next artist on after you go to if you're going to tell stories at Alice about Kerry, I'm not sure if there's anybody from Kerry here, but there were two boys from the city, from Dublin, motoring around Kerry, and it was getting dark, and they were running out of Pethard, and it was looking bad. But finally they come around a corner, and sure enough, a three-year-old house, and a big chapel, and a pub on this side, and a petrol pump. Bingo, we'll get the petrol. Into the wee woman, we're looking for petrol here. Ah, oh, no, there's no petrol. There's no petrol today. The lorry won't be here till the morning. Ah, well, we're here for the night then. Where's the hotel? Oh, there's no hotel. This place is too small, you know. But I could give you bread and breakfast, if that's any good. So they had the bed and breakfast, and in the morning the lorry came, and they got their petrol, and away they went. And about 2 months after that, one of these boys got a letter. And when he got it, he went to the other fella. He says, tell me this. He says, do you remember the night we stayed with the wee woman in Kerry? I do. Did you go to bed with that woman that night? Aye, I believe it did. Aye. And did you give her my name and address? I think you did. Man, you're the right old bastard, do you? I'm sorry. I shouldn't have done that, I'm sorry. Oh, you're sorry, but you'll be sorrier. That one died 2 months ago when she left the pub to me. The boy got from Boston to play golf in Killarney, and he had a few drinks on the plane. When he got to Killarney, he went into the pub and he had a brief old drop a drink in him, and he started to bum about the great golfer he was. I played with Jack Nicklaus and Arnold Palmer and those guys. Yeah. As a matter of fact, I would challenge any one of you guys for a round of golf. What do you say? 100 euro? Yeah, okay. Wasn't any of these boys, but there was a wee fella at the head of the bar with a pair of green Wellingtons on him and a long coat and a belt around. I might take you on, he says. Yeah, okay, 100 euro, right? 100 euro, right. Tomorrow. Mm-hmm. 10 o'clock. Aye, the Kerry man says, well, I might be half an hour late. That's all right, I'll wait for you. But when the American got up, the wee Kerry man was there, and three golf clubs were left-handed golf clubs. That's all he had, and he thrashed the American off the course. American couldn't live on it at all. I wasn't expecting that, says the American. Here's your 100 euro. Listen, we'll do it again tomorrow, right? Doubles or quits? Aye, that'll do, says the Kerry man. 10 o'clock again, is it? 10 o'clock, yeah, that's all right. Mm-hmm. I might be half an hour late. Oh, that's okay, I'll wait for you. But when the American got up there, the wee Kerry man was there. Three right-handed golf clubs, this time. The American couldn't live on him. Thrashed him by a terrible score. He says, I didn't realise you were so good. How do you do it? Well, you are right-handed clubs today, left-handed clubs yesterday. Smashed everything, birdied everything inside. Ah, well, it's simple enough, says the Kerry man, you see. When I get up in the morning, if the wife is lying on her left-hand side of the bed, well, then I play with the left-handed clubs. And if she's lying on the right-hand side, I play with the right-hand clubs. It's simple. It doesn't seem to go wrong, you know. Yeah, says the man. Yeah, but, well, if she's lying on her back, man, what do you do? Oh, well, then I'd be half an hour late.
Show a couple of the videos. We don't have time for all of them, but we'll put them all up online and then we'll finish off. We're going to have I think Ellie Kate's going to dance first, and then we're going to have all the grandchildren on the stage and we'll all sing a few wee songs, a few medleys together. So, Michael, you're up.
Come on.
Yeah. Usually we save the best to last.
A wee man went to the doctor. He said to the doctor, he said, I've got a hereditary disease. The doctor said to him, what's wrong with you? He said, I've diarrhea. The doctor said to him, he said, diarrhea is not a hereditary disease. But he said, it's in my genes. Wee boy came to school, he was late. The school teacher said to him, what kept you? He said, I was eating my breakfast. He said, what did you have for your breakfast? He said, I had a boiled egg. And he said, get in there. He said, you're late for school. And his brother came in 5 minutes later. And his teacher said, where were you? He said, I was having my breakfast. He said, what did you have for your breakfast? He said, I had a boiled egg. And he said, your brother had a boiled egg and he's here 5 minutes before you. Had I a spoon, had I?
Dragging on, and I hear
Hello, Barney, it's Daniel here. Sorry that I can't be with you in person on this very, very special evening, but I'm delighted to be able to get the message sent by a video to wish you a very, very happy birthday and how I would love to be there to see you in the circle back together again. Many's a good night we enjoyed in your company and danced the feet of ourselves and always enjoyed all the music. I hope you have a great night and hopefully I'll see you somewhere. And good luck to you and hello to everybody there. And I don't want to be taking up too much time, but sure, I'll sing a wee verse.
I've just stepped in to see you. I'll only stay a while. I want to see you. Are you getting on? I want to see you smile. I'm happy to be back again, to meet you big and small. For there's no place else on earth just like the homes of the being of. That's enough from me. Have a great night and many more birthdays to come. And greetings to Catherine and all the family.
Thanks. Ladies and gentlemen, John and Sheila, we need your help. There's a very special guest. We haven't heard from Daniel. There's a few more lovely requests coming up, but maybe look at them online. We have a very special new guest. She only responds well to massive applause. Everybody say hello, Ellie Kate.
Hello.
You want to dance with Grandpa?
Yeah.
Thank you. you all know that. And then it was I think it was Orla had a great idea as well. Okay, so.
The place I was born.
Jambalaya.
Charlie, see.
Charlie.
Goodbye, Joe. We gotta go.
On Daddy's birthday for everybody that was here tonight as well. So if you check the Donegal Hospice webpage, because I'd rather that Isabel that's in the hospice, and Alan, they've been absolutely brilliant. I like to focus on the stage part of things, and I'm leaving all those people all the work to do with money. And I would like to really, really thank Sarah and Elaine and Mary and Kayla and Mum and Isabel and everybody who made this happen, and you guys tonight. I really think we set off with a target of €2,000 here alone tonight, without the raffle and without the online donations. We've certainly, certainly smashed that target out of the water. So thank you so much. We will. Thank you. We will, as I say, we will keep the singing going out there for the wee small hours for those of you that are not over 85. Fergus, that means you as well.
Right,
folks. Red Barney, Rose of
Ironmore. See them. Talk today, though.
Call you clear of lovely green, you know.
Tommy, Michael, and for Martin, Patrick, Noel, Fergus, for everybody that sent videos, and there's about five or six more, but again, we put them up online and they'll also be on the Amharclann page and that as well. This party is not finished tonight, it's only starting. Bring on September for all the children that are here, for Kieran and Nee Hackett up there on the desk, Manus, and all the staff of our clan, especially the girls out there who are just dying to entertain you for the next few hours. And go ahead, special to, ain't the special to an art. It's hard to believe when you talk about 38 years, 39 years since the circle were together, that's actually half his lifetime ago practically. So if you give him, just for the last time tonight, a big round of your applause. Appreciate it.
John and Mary anniversary today, is that right?
What?
John McDaid and Mary. And Terrell from, Mary's from Terrell and John from, that would be a brother of Joey's, the long man. It's their anniversary today. So, F.
Okay, this isn't over, since we are.
Show me the way to go.
Now, shall I fade off? Funny how it takes me back to when I was a child. On rainy days, in many ways, the sun still shone for me. Oh, I hope they know before they grow what the old man means to me. Watch him play accordion and sing comedy songs. Though I never know the words, I somehow sing along. The children smile once in a while while making fun of me. Oh, I hope they know before they grow what the old man means to me. A golden ring. Love is found full circle. Love is bound by family.